Hello guys, good morning, hope you're okay. Just to let you know, it's really quite beautiful here in Glenstal at this stage. There's lovely lighting, there's beautiful shadows, the flowers are coming out, it's like really spring and it's really nice, okay? Anyway, back to reality, especially reality in Italy, because the abbot here, Brendan, he gave me a copy of a letter that he got from a friend of a friend, who's a doctor in the epicenter of the coronavirus problem in Italy, in a place called Bergamo. And I thought it was really good. So I'm just gonna read it out and that's it, okay? Never in my darkest nightmares, says this doctor, have I imagined that I could see and experience what has been going on here in our hospital for the last 3 weeks. The nightmare flows. The river gets bigger and bigger. At first some came, then dozens, then hundreds, and now we are no longer doctors, but we have become sorters on the conveyor belt. And we decide who should live and who should be sent home to die. Even if all these people have paid their Italian taxes all their life. Until 2 weeks ago, my colleagues and I were atheists. It was normal because we're doctors and we learned that science excludes the presence of God. Trash. Anyway, I always laughed at my parents going to church every Sunday. 9 days ago, a 70-year-old man came to us. He was a kind man. He had serious breathing problems, but he also had a Bible with him. And he impressed us all greatly. He read his Bible to the dying and held them by the hand. We were all tired, discouraged, psychologically and physically exhausted doctors, but we always found time to listen to him. There was something different about him. Now we have to admit, we as humans have reached our limits. We can't manage. More and more people die every day. And we're exhausted. We have two colleagues who have died, and others have been infected. We realize that we are at the limit of what man can do, and we do need God. And we started asking for help from him when we have a few free minutes. We talk to each other and we cannot believe that as ferocious atheists, we are now every day in the search of peace, asking the Lord to help us endure so that we can take care of the sick. Yesterday, that 75-year-old man died. But until that moment, despite having had over 120 deaths in 3 weeks here and being all exhausted and destroyed, that man had managed, despite his condition and our difficulties, to bring us a peace that we no longer hoped to find. That man went to the Lord, and soon we will follow him too, if things continue like this. I haven't been home for 6 days, and I don't know when I last ate, and I realize my worthlessness on this earth, but I want to take my last breath while helping others. I'm happy to have returned to God, even though I'm surrounded by the suffering and death of my fellow human beings. Well, I found that very moving and an interesting comment on the existence of God as well. So, hope you learned from it. Let's just say a prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. All the best.